The climate is getting colder, as can be seen here by the snows creeping ever further southwards from the north. The cheeky Geats were in my territory, which I didn't much like them doing. Seemed a bit aggressive to me, so I showed them what happens when you mess with the Jutes. I killed their entire army, and now I am in a decent position to take their capital, Hafnesholt, which has been my number one priority from the start of this campaign. However, I have had to deal with a significant amount of incursions, destroying all of my neighbors. So, without further ado, let's just go over here and crush the Geats. Now, there's going to be a bit more ado, because I want to merge a few units. And that allows me to recruit a few more cheap units, which is nice. These skirmishers are just awesome in campaign. They are super cheap, and I have seen them get close to 398 kills is the most I've seen them get, actually, which is not bad for a skirmish unit. So I'm going to go in by sea and land. Let's see if I can do that in a single turn. Seems like I can, actually, if I just move over like so. Of course. Is there nothing else? Cool. Now it looks like I could just attack here and take out Hafnesholt. I wasn't impressed with the mercenary step. I'm not impressed with the mercenary step lancers. They die very easily. But I do not have a lot of cavalry at this time, so I'm just going to keep them in. Now I will disband this unit, and let's see if I can hire some mercenaries that are worth a damn in close combat. Because I do have my ranged capabilities are good, I just need units able to kill something in close combat. So the mercenary Nordic axes are very cheap indeed. So I think I'm going to just disband my steplancers and hire in some Nordic axe warriors, and I will of course disband them after they have fought and died here, because they are way too expensive to keep in. Looks good. Can I? I think I can recruit. Yeah, I can recruit another one. And the mercenary Nordic brigade. I guess they are nice as a sort of a meat shield unit. But I do want. I'm going to merge these units because I do want the third axe units. I haven't used axes in this campaign yet, so I'm going to do it now. And let's attack Hafnesholt. It does not, this settlement does not have a chance. I am a bit worried though that the Geats have that they have an army somewhere I can't see, because they did have a significant army and navy at some point, and I'm not sure where that went. So if it suddenly starts invading my holdings in mainland Europe, I might be in trouble. But I should be able to take it back fairly easily. So the plan is here to just... I don't want to burn down the city too much this time. That was mostly for fun in the other battles. I'll try to take the city with as few casualties as possible. With as little burning of down of the settlement as possible, since I do plan on settling here. So ideally, I want to force entry where there are as few towers as possible, and this looks like a decent enough spot for that. So let's start deploying here. My mercenary Nordic Axe Warriors are going to be my rush in and die units. Then I have all of the skirmishers here. Cavalry here. Let's see how this goes. I'll just destroy a segment of the wall.
Reinforcing troops, and not a moment too soon.
And here come my reinforcements in perfect position to aid in the assault. I quite like these low tier armies. Just keeping it low tier and interesting for as long as possible. I'm not going to rush the military tech to get good units as quickly as possible, because that is not enjoyable to me. We almost have a breach in the wall now, 50% there. Then we can send in troops over here. It looks like the ships might be interested in landing here, so I'm going to create a defensive line here with both skirmishers and infantry, like so. Keep the dogs there as well. Then I can use the Mercenary Nordic Brigade to hold them down here. That should be fine. Almost created an opening. In a way, I feel a bit bad for the Geats, because the Geats haven't done... They haven't bothered me at all. They've been, aside from the one incursion where they didn't do anything, they've been trading partners, and they have just kept building up their forces, but at some point it was going to be me or them, I think. At some point the Geats were probably going to try to challenge my...
The enemy's walls crumble before our might.
To challenge me for control of Scandinavia. And we can't have that. Let's just try to make the hole in the wall a bit bigger.
The enemy has been spotted.
Okay, here they are. This is, let's see, Nordic Light Marauders. Just land already. Here we are.
Missile armed warriors. Many fighters ready. Warhounds.
Guess we can use the dogs here as well.
Ready for battle.
They do take their sweet time. Orders. I have this nice ridge here that I can use to defend.
Forward. Missile armed warriors.
Start firing on those light marauders. Here.
Warhounds!
These guys are going to die quickly. still can't attack them while they are disembarking, which is annoying as hell. Spearmen ready for battle. Look at this, I can't attack them now. I have to wait until every single man has disembarked. I still can't attack them. That's buggy. Those guys are dying. Very nice. Now, too bad that the Marauder units and the different naval units aren't available as just standard land units. There was no difference between Norse units at sea, and they didn't have special marines or anything like that. They just had warriors. The warriors that could row, warriors that could fight on land, warriors that could fight on sea. Didn't have dedicated marines because most warriors were able to fight at sea, which I guess would be one of the differences between Vikings and other European armies, that you wouldn't just be able to put an army on a ship and then it would be able to fight as an effective navy, whereas the Vikings were dual purpose in that regard. Let's just finish off these ships and then use the mercenary onager to punch a hole in the fort wall. Try to kill these Norse bow marauders. I could just send in some dogs here, I guess. I think those units are out of range of my skirmishers. But these units are just able to reload and reload and reload. So maybe I should try to kill them with the onager. Is the onager missing a lot now, or does it just seem like it? I was probably firing at units that were running away. Okay, Nordic bows are actually able to kill something. That's amazing. Kill the other ship too. Send out the dogs. See how well the axe warriors are able to do over there. The Nordic brigade as well. Here you can see that the arrow towers are firing at the dogs, and then they're also causing friendly fire casualties. It looks like the dogs are running out of the settlement. I don't remember telling them to come back. My boats are almost out of ammo now. It looks like I might just have to tolerate that ship. Move up from the Sure, in that case.
One of our units can no longer fire.
What are these dogs? Okay, they are just standing at the red line. That's inconvenient. Let's just rest these guys down here. So instead of attacking units in here, they are running out of the settlement to go over and bark at the red line. That is great. See, things like this really reduce the enjoyment of a game.
They will bleed for us.
Units just doing annoying stuff. Glitching out, not able to work, essentially.
The men are broken and are fleeing. Get running. Ready.
Send the axe warband. These are just throwaway units, so I don't really care if they die. But it would be nice if my dogs stopped just standing around and barking. I could, of course, try to call them back by putting the handlers. Yeah, it looks like they're going to start running back here. That's nice, at least. Very nice.
Ready for battle. Kill, kill, kill.
Just go and attack these this battle. Nordic band.
Warhounds. Ready for battle. Warhounds.
Come on.
The men have thrown down their weapons and are fleeing.
Nordic Levy is one sturdy unit at this point in the game. We're very impressed by how well they're able to perform. Let's rush up with the dogs. I have so many units left. And here comes the dogs. Go, dogs. Finish off the Nordic levy. Looks like I might have to send in my other units soon, because these units are taking a beating from the tower. Let's just send the dogs out to hopefully manage to run down the routing units. And then just send in a ton of Nordic levy. Maybe I can try to kill them with my horse archers.
We hunger for blood and battle.
Or do the dogs actually manage to kill these guys? Yep. Looks like they do. And some of you have asked me why I bother running down units and asking in ways or telling me that I shouldn't run down units. You get experience for running down units. The Jutes have a faction-specific trait that gives you money for destroying enemy units. Now, how, when a unit is considered destroyed, I do not know, but if there are a significant amount of men left in a unit, I'm still going to kill that unit just for the experience, because I like it. Also because I like killing routing enemy troops. So I am open for suggestions on how to play the campaign better, but first priority here is enjoying the campaign, not playing a perfect campaign. That is boring as hell.
An entire unit has perished.
These Nordic skirmishers might get eaten by dogs. The dogs are not very effective troops. They are effective. They are effective if they are able to. If they are able to attack units that are on the move, they can actually do some damage. But against units that actually stand and fight the dogs, it usually doesn't end too well for the dogs. Let's just rest a bit, because these guys are exhausted. Go over and attack the Nordic brigands. Guess I could use... I just don't want to get too close to the... to the towers, because then I'm going to lose a lot of cavalry.
Spears ready!
Can I attack the tower from here? Looks like I... Wow, I can actually attack the tower from here. That's interesting. So the dogs took care of the Nordic skirmishers, but I think they're out of ammo anyway. Now we can send in the infantry. While burning down the tower with torches. Cavalry is running around trying to kill some routing enemies. This tower is just about gone.
Men of the North!
Oh, Thrytle spears. Or Thrytle spute mother. They should die very quickly. They do not have armor and very low health, so my levies should do a good job against them. Looks like I caught up to this unit over here. I can attack them. Just rush in and take the capture points. The dogs are running after these Nordic skirmishers, which is very nice. Send in these guys as well. Just turn Farad Will off so they don't kill each other. Go and take the gatehouse. Those Nordic brigands took a long time to die. Taking fire from machine gun towers from all angles here.
Kill.
That's the most annoying part of sieges, just towers without men in them. If you could put archers in towers, that would be very cool. But having it like this with the machine gun towers, nah. Here you can see the dogs are actually capturing the gatehouse for me. Which is very nice.
This bodes well.
Just finish up those spears. It looks they haven't killed the Nordic brigands yet. Let's move further into the city. This gatehouse should be captured soon. Impressive how long they take to kill a few units of Nordics. Okay, so now I can go and take care of the Nordic levy and
the enemy's tower has been destroyed.
Nordic levy general. And now the enemy tower finally is down. Very nice for me. Let's just rest a bit over here. Just fast forward while I rest and do... while I rest and stuff. Send the Nordic levy over here. Now I can start sending the skirmishers and stuff into the settlement. These guys are taking fire from... the boat that refused to die. Let's just see if they're more effective if they just fire on the routing units. I think they might be. Oh, come on. They burned up my onagers. Okay, so here we took that capture point. I'm just going to brush for the central capture point. Oh, it looks like the bow marauders have actually... are they being eaten by dogs?
Dogs be good.
No.
We are moments away from
victory. The enemy just routed, so okay. Cool, very nice. Decisive victory there against the Geats. The battle took long enough. Chop down the Geats. Will the Geats become a horde faction? Do they have armies left at all? Let's see. Let's just occupy.
Journey completed.
Nice. Scandinavia is finally mine.
Ready for battle.
And I can now disband the expensive units. Good.
Ready for battle.
Looks like we got some abilities here. Mentor. Local province, nope. He can have some stuff in his household. Diadem, backquiver, Aaron Ag... on Baragbud uniform. Minus 10 for ranged infantry. Pancration gloves. Pancration gloves are going to be nice when I'm going to actually be recruiting melee infantry, I guess. But I am not really doing that yet. Statuette of Zeus. 10 plus 10 morale for pagan armies. Legionary Patera. Minus 10 for melee infantry. I don't think that applies to spears. Correct me if I'm wrong. Campaign ladder, campaign spotting chance, campaign line of sight plus 30%. Not bad, I guess. The statuette of Ziu seems nice. I also quite like the ladder, just increased spotting distance, but I guess that that matters. Well, okay, I'm going to do that. Because this is a levy army. Slave trader, recruit, research rate for civil developments. Yes, please. Okay, so Hugleike can get the wolf, which increases his seal. The hunter, the infantry commander. Let's give him a point in... Let's see, let's give him a point in wolf. And then in, let's see, infantry commander leads to cavalry commander. I quite like the double wolf to begin with.
Thirsty for battle.
So let's just merge these units. Okay. Yeah, it's faster to do it like this, I guess. Okay, they are merged, and I'll just disband this one unit. Helps a bit with the economy, at least.
Warriors all.
Yeah, I'll just disband the brigands. Disband these units. And... yep. I kind of want to keep the onager, because it gives me a few interesting tactical options. And...
ready for battle.
Wait until next turn to move. I am very weak over here, which kind of worries me a bit. Because I was at war with the Rugians. But it looks like the Burgundians might have done something about the Rugians, not entirely sure. Colonia Agrippina belongs to the Suebians. Here we have the Alamans and the Langobards. We have the whole DLC bunch down here. Well, let's have a look at the diplomacy.
Greetings.
Get any trade agreements with people, or any non-aggression pacts, maybe.
I welcome you, worthy speaker. I listen.
Low chance of success. Caledonians can't trade with the Caledonians. The Langobards, see if they want
sit,
to trade.
Friend, and let us talk.
Okay, so I might have to just kill the Langobards then, which suits me fine. Do the Western Romans want
let
to trade
talk
with me?
And then enjoy good Rome.
No, they do not. Okay, so the Geats have actually made a horde, but they are so far away from. They are so far away. Let's see where they are. Let's see if I bring up the diplomacy tab again. Yeah, the Geats. Wow. The Geats are outside of modern-day France, Lugdunensis, so I guess it's going to be quite some time until I see the Geats. Both the Franks, Geats, and Saxons are in horde mode at the moment, which is nice for me. So now I'll just end the turn, because I kind of want to see how much money I made from killing all of those... killing all of those enemy units. So here we have the military jetties. Perfect. I'm going to start recruiting longboats. Then we have the fields. Don't think fields are a good thing to have over here. And then we have the clay pit. I don't like the clay pit. And then we have a prime forest. So yeah, I guess that's good to have wood production. Okay. A jetty. Maybe fishing jetties. Fishing jetties. Squalor plus 2, public order minus 2, plus 50 food. Yeah, let's just build us a few fishing jetties, end the turn, and see what happens. Oh, before I end the turn, maybe I should check to see if the loyalty is fine here. 9 out of 10. 9 out of 10. 9 out of 10. Loyalty is fine. These guys have been 8 turns in office, it seems like. So let's just end the turn and see if they get anything out of it, because I don't know if they do. Okay, Wolfgar has an unassigned skill. He also has he has a wife that reduces his cunning but increases his authority. Now Wolfgar is, let's see here what Wolfgar is up to. I don't remember where I have Wolfgar. Let's see here. Wolfgar has, oh, he's done a few things. Let's see here, Wolfgar, where are you? Wolfgar is a governor in Frisia, okay. And let's see. So Wolfgar is a governor in Frisia. Has authority plus 2. Food from character when, from characters when governed. But I don't have food problems just yet. The spoiler infantry. Judge Raven, construction cost minus 10. I guess that's nice in Frisia. Construction cost minus 20. Yeah, let's just give him the Raven. And then the other guy who had skills was, let's see here, it was Gutulf. And Gutulf is going to become an epic commander. Cavalry commander. I don't have much cavalry yet. The stag is nice, minus 10 fatigue rate. But the cavalry commander is also nice. Increased battle movement speed, and yeah, I quite like that one. And Gutulf can have Statute of Zeu. And he can have Diadem, I guess. Okay, let's end the turn now and see what happens. Maybe the Geats are going to settle further down in Europe. What I am a bit interested in checking out here is my finance scroll. See how I don't think it's specified how much I get from the despoiler trait, but I do think I can see how much money I make from other sources, and some of that should be from the despoiler trait, at least since I had a few battles. Let's see. Yeah, Huglaik has completed his term in office, so has Gutulf, and so has Gorulf. So, good thing that I waited. Wolfgar is at plus 3 loyalty, very nice. This embezzlement plot, once revealed, started an investigation leading all the way back to you. Oh, the shame. So, minus 25 influence, minus 10 control. And it happened again. And the balance of power is 62%. So my control is not great at the moment. Interesting. But yeah, we'll see how that plays out a bit later. Gather support. So let's just gather support with Gutulf. Can't gather support with Getwolf because he has no influence over his faction whatsoever. That's nice. Now, if I appoint Gutulf to be an elder, and Gorulf can't be an elder, Hugleikr to be... Let's see, maybe Hugleikr can be... he was already a companion. So make him an elder and make Wulfgar... I can't make Wulfgar an elder, but I can make Wulfgar a companion. Let's just try that, see how that plays out. And now I can start... I don't think I need to defend Hafnarsholt much. It's far away from anything scary that could be happening. Oh, let's have a look at the... let's have a look at the trade and finance. Income, last turn, 8,000. Trade, military looting. Ransom from battle captives, diplomacy, other. So did I get 8,200 from other? Oh well.
Ready for orders.
Let's send Kongsherden back to Alabu. No, do not take that route. Go over the sea, please.
Getting on our way.
I guess I could just double time it and get back to Alabu. Yep, indeed I could. Well, let's see here. Goat pens, that's good. Artisan. Let's see, clay pit, smithy. Bone carver. Wood carver. I didn't like any of those particularly much. Let's see, I could upgrade the Inhofen to a village, but let's just wait a bit. And I want the majority of my army to be, I think down here is where it's going to be going down, so to speak. So I am going to have my armies down there. Let's see, I might be a bit heavy on the skirmishers now, but I quite like them. Let's see if we can build something in Frisia. City sanitation seems like a wise choice. Hunting lodges, resource production, 31st. Chieftain's house, goat herd. Well, I can upgrade this to Thraus in Angulus. And then I can upgrade to, let's see, hunting lodges maybe. Food, commerce, resource production. Yeah, that seems nice. So I think we're going to end this chapter of Saga of the Jutes. Finally, a unified Scandinavia up here. Very happy about that. So now I can start concentrating on securing my borders. And then it's time to... First, I'm going to try to... stabilize the position in... I might take these provinces as well. I might take Gothic Gansa as well. It would be nice to have control over the... Over here as well. It would be nice to have control over the entire coastline here. But of course, that's going to be harder to defend. And then we're going to be taking a look at Britain. I think I'm going to need a strong economy to be able to handle that, especially if the other nations start destroying cities and such, then that's going to be very expensive for me. But Scandinavia unified, the first step on the way to world domination for the Jutes. Strength and honor.